Hello everyone, and welcome to Sign of Our Time. Today I want to answer the question, what are polynomials? Well, let's start by breaking up the word polynomial into two parts, poly and nomial. Poly stems from a Greek word that means many, while nomial stems from the Latin word nomen, meaning name. In mathematics, this simply means terms. So essentially, polynomials means many terms. Now, if you don't know what a term is, don't worry. Sit back, relax. We'll get back to that at the end of this lesson. For now though, I want to focus on that word polynomial. And more specifically, I want to focus on the prefix, and that is poly. Prefix just means the beginning of the word or the start of the word. Because that prefix is used in many other words that you may know of. And it serves the same function in all of those words because it means many. For example, if we take the word polygon, which also has the prefix poly, a polygon is a flat, two-dimensional shape that can have many sides. Examples of polygons include triangles, which have three sides, squares, which have four sides, pentagons have five sides, hexagons have six sides, and so on. Have you ever wondered why they call a lie detector test a polygraph? Well, a polygraph is a machine that measures and graphs many physiological indicators, and these range from blood pressure, to pulse, to respiration, to skin conductivity, and so on. How about that word polygamy? Now, polygamy is the practice of marrying many spouses, which interestingly still takes place in much of the world today. Finally, what about that word polyatomic? Do you want to take a guess as to what polyatomic means? Well, if you put two and two together, you'll know that polyatomic means consisting of many atoms. Now that we have a better understanding that poly means many, what about the prefix mono? Well, mono just means one of something. You may have heard of the word monocle before, but if not, well, there's a new word for you today. Today, everyone thinks that walking around with glasses, which means two eyepieces, is fashionable. Forget about that. Go back to the late 19th century where the monocle was the fashion statement. All a monocle is one eyepiece. If you are into literature, you may have come across the word monologue. Let me demonstrate. A monologue is a long speech by one actor in a play. Not because the actor is senile. Not because they don't have any friends, but because it was just a common thing in Shakespearean times. Okay, that's enough Shakespeare for one day. Let's look at other words that have the prefix mono. For example, monorail, which is just a railroad that consists of one track. Or how about monocular? A monocular is essentially a pair of binoculars cut in half so that you just have one viewing tube, essentially a telescope. Or how about monopoly? A monopoly is one business that dominates an entire industry and has no real competitors. What about the word monotonous? A person's voice is said to be monotonous if it has one pitch that is unchanging and has no expression or intonation. Now, let's move on to the prefix bi, which is used to represent two of something. Take bicycle, for example. A bicycle is essentially a frame that has two wheels attached to it. Or what about a biathlon? A biathlon is a winter sport that consists of two races. namely cross-country skiing and rifle shooting. What about binary? Binary is a code that is used in digital computers that represents two states, on and off, and those are usually represented by ones and zeros. Binoculars are basically two telescopes mounted side by side, one for each eye, in order to view distant objects. A bikini is... No one says bikini, right? No? Bikini. Okay. Bikini. A bikini is a swimsuit that essentially has two pieces. And finally, what about someone who suffers from bipolar disorder? Basically, they experience two extreme moods, ranging from extreme highs to extreme lows. Finally, let's move on to the prefix tri, which essentially means three of something. For example, a triangle has three sides as well as three angles. Or a tricycle is essentially a frame that has three wheels attached to it. When a number is tripled, it is multiplied by three. When you are playing darts and a single dart hits triple 20, that score multiplies by three in order to get you 60. What about a tripod? A tripod is a stand that has three legs. Or how about triplets? Triplets are three children that are born to the same mother at the same time. In summary, mono means one, bi means two, tri means three, and poly means many. As promised earlier, let's go back and explain what we mean by a term in mathematics. A term could just be a number, such as 5 or negative 17. It could be a single variable, which is essentially a letter, such as W or P. It could be a combination of variables, such as AB, T squared, X squared, Y, Z cubed, as long as the exponents of the variables are all positive. And it can also be a combination of numbers and variables. For example, 6x, negative 2mn, or 31p to the power of 5, q to the power of 4. Now, if you're feeling overwhelmed with all of this new terminology that is being thrown at you, such as expression and exponent and coefficient and constant and variable and term, don't you worry. We are going to put all of these pieces together using a very simple example, such as 5x squared minus 7. Starting on the left-hand side, if you get a number that appears before a letter, that number is referred to as a coefficient. The letter itself is referred to as a variable. Now, sometimes to the right of that variable, we see a little number that appears as a superscript, and that is referred to as an exponent. Sometimes what you might see is a number that appears by itself, without a variable, and this is referred to as a constant. In this example, we have two terms, and together those two terms make up an algebraic expression. Finally, let's get down to the crux of this lesson. A monomial is an algebraic expression with one term only. For example, 7, negative 3a, 4p squared, negative 10x, y to the power of 5, z to the power of 3. These are all examples of monomials. A binomial is an algebraic expression that consists of two terms, and those two terms are separated by plus or minus signs. For example, x plus 1, or 2a plus 3b, or negative 2pq squared plus 7, or 9x to the power of 4 minus 10y to the power of 5. A trinomial is an algebraic expression that consists of three terms, and those three terms are also separated by plus or minus signs. For example, 3x squared plus 2y minus z. We also get 1 plus 5a minus b squared. How about p squared plus q cubed minus 2r to the power of 4? Finally, how about negative m squared, negative 3mn plus 4n squared? These are all examples of trinomials. And finally, monomials, binomials, and trinomials are all examples of polynomials. They all fall under the umbrella of polynomials. Well, I hope you have a better understanding of what polynomials are and how to identify different types of polynomials, such as monomials, binomials, and trinomials. Well, that's all from me, and I want to say a very big thank you for watching.